Hello dear students, today we start chapter 12, topic ratio and proportion, part 1, means in this chapter we studied about ratio. Here we learned about some basic instruction or introduction, ratios, equivalent ratio, related examples, common mistakes related to ratio and some example with solution. Now, basic introduction. Students, in our daily life, many times we compare the two quantities of same type. For comparing quantities, we commonly use the method of taking difference between the quantity. For example, Lina and Rima playing marbles. Lina has 30 marbles and Rima has 18 marbles. Difference between the marbles equals to 30 minus 18 gives 12. Therefore, we can say that Lina has 12 marbles more than Rima, or Rima has 12 marbles less than the marbles Lina has. This is the way of comparison by taking difference. Now ratio. To understand the ratio, first we take one example. Suppose Rahul's age is 10 years and age of Meena is 5 years. How can we compare their ages? By above taking difference method. By above method, we can find the differences of ages is equals to 10 minus 5 equals to 5 years. So, age of Rahul is 5 years more than age of Meena. There are one other method for comparison, that is division method. If we divide age of Rahul by age of Meena, then we get age of Rahul divided by age of Meena equals 10 by 5, that means 2 by 1 equals to 2. Therefore, age of Rahul equals to 2 times the age of Meena. Here, 2 by 1 is ratio of age of Rahul to age of Meena. Ratio is denoted by symbol dot, two dots, that means colon. Note that a ratio is treated as fraction. So we can write age of Rahul ratio, age of Meena equals to 2 ratio 1. Similarly, age of Meena ratio, age of Rahul equals to 1 ratio 2. Note that here 2 ratio 1 is not equals to 1 ratio 2. If we take age of Rahul in months and age of Meena in years. So, age of Rahul 10 years, that means 10 into 12 because 1 year is equals to 12 months. Therefore, 10 years equals to 10 into 12, 120 months. And age of Meena equals to 5 years. Here we take Rahul's age in months and Meena's age in years. And then we find the ratio. Therefore, ratio is age of Rahul ratio age of Meena equals to 120 ratio 5. If we divide 120 and 5 by 5, then we get the least form 24 ratio 1. It means age of Rahul is 24 times of age of Meena, which is wrong. Therefore, to find the ratio between two quantities, their unit must be same. If we cannot make unit same, then our result will be wrong. Now, If we find age of Rahul and Meena both in months, then age of Rahul equals to 10 years means 10 into 12, 120 months. And age of Meena equals to 5 years, that means 5 into 12 equals to 60 months. Now we find the ratio. Age of Rahul ratio, age of Meena equals to 120 ratio 60. Therefore, if we divide 120 and 60 by 60, because the HCF of 120 and 60 is 60. So, we get the least form of 120 ratio 60 is 2 ratio 1. So, 120 ratio 60 equals to 2 ratio 1. In above, we see that 10 ratio 5 is also 2 ratio 1. Therefore, 10 ratio 5 equals to 120 ratio 60 equals to 2 ratio 1. It proves that to find the ratio, always both quantities are in the same units. Now, equivalent ratio. Students, we know that in a fraction, we can multiply or divide by same number in its numerator and denominator, and it gives same value. That means there is no change in the value. For example, 10 by 5. In fraction 10 by 5, if we divide numerator 10 and denominator 5 by 5, then we get 2 ratio 1. That means 2. Similarly, the fraction 120 divided by 60 is equals to, if we divide 120 and 60 by 60, then we get the ratio 2 ratio 1. So, 10 ratio 5 equals to 120 ratio 60 is equals to 2 ratio 1. Now, in division, if we multiply the fraction, then we get the another result. Now, 10 by 5 is equals to 10 into 2 by 5 into 2 gives 20 by 10, that means 20 ratio 10. Similarly, 120 divided by 60 is equals to 120, if we divide numerator by 4 and denominator by 4, then we get the least form is 30 by 15. That means 30 ratio 15. Here, 2 ratio 1 equals to 10 ratio 5 equals to 120 ratio 60 equals to 20 ratio 10 equals to 30 ratio 15. That means the least value of all those ratios are 2 ratio 1. Value of all above ratios are equal. Therefore, these ratios are called equivalent ratio. That is, ratios having equal least values are called equivalent ratio. In above example, age of Rahul divided by age of Meena equals to 10 by 5. Here, years is common in the numerator and denominator, denominator of fraction. So, it can be cancelled. Therefore, age of Rahul divided by age of Meena, we can write 10 by 5 equals to least form 2 by 1. That means 2 ratio 1. Therefore, we can say that ratio has no unit. Now, the common mistakes related to ratio. Students, we see that many times some students make common mistakes. We discuss this by taking some examples. Example 1. Monthly income of Dinesh is rupees 12,000. He saves rupees 5,000. Find the ratio of his saving to his expenditure. Some students find simply ratio of given numbers, like 12,000 divided by 5,000. That means 12,000 ratio 5,000. If both divided by 1000, then we get the least form 12:5. Then students think that 12:5 is the correct answer. But this is the mistake, because we have to find the ratio of saving to his expenditure. Here expenditure is not given. Actually, we have to find first expenditure. So expenditure equals to monthly income minus saving. That means 12,000 minus 5,000 equals to rupees 7,000. Now ratio of saving to expenditure is equals to 5,000:7,000 gives 5:7. Again, one type of mistakes students done. Some students find the ratio 7,000:5,000. That means 7:5. This is the ratio of expenditure to saving, not ratio of saving to expenditure. So the correct ratio of saving to expenditure is 5,000:7,000. That means 5:7. Example 2. Anu has a ribbon of length 6 meter and width 30 centimeter. Find the ratio of length of ribbon to its width. The length of ribbon is 6 meter and width is 30 centimeter. Students find the ratio in given number. They are not changing their units. Length of ribbon ratio width of ribbon equals to 6:30. If we divide 6 and 30 by 6, then we get the ratio 1:5. Here, length is less than width, which is wrong. For correct solution, here first we have to convert both quantities in same unit. Length of ribbon is equals to 6 meter, that means 600 centimeter, because 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter. And width of ribbon is equals to 30 centimeter. It is already given in centimeter. So both the values are in centimeter. Therefore, we can find the ratio. Length of ribbon ratio width of ribbon is equals to 600 divided by 30 equals to 20:1. Now, example 3. Some students think that ratio is the actual quantities. For example, ratio of number of candies of Meena to Mahesh is equals to 4:5. Some students think that number of candies with Meena equals to 4 and number of candies with Mahesh equals to 5, which is not correct, because ratios 8:10, 12:15, 16:20 also gives the same least value 4:5. Therefore, value in numerator and denominator of a ratio are not the actual values. It is the least form of the actual quantities. Actual quantities are the multiple of least of the ratio, least form of the ratio. Some more examples. Find ratio of 90 centimeter to 1.5 meter. Solution. We know that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So 1.5 meter is equals to 1.5 into 100, that means 150 centimeter. Therefore, ratio of 90 centimeter to 1.5 meter equals to ratio of 90 centimeter to 150 centimeter equals to 90:150, which gives the least value 3:5. Next example. Give two equivalent ratios of 10:6. 10:6 means 10 by 6. If we multiply numerator and denominator by 2, then we get 10 into 2 by 6 into 2 equals to 20 by 12. That means 20:12. Again, 10:6 equals to 10 by 6. If we divide numerator and denominator by 2, then we get 10 divided by 2 by 6 divided by 2 equals to 5 by 3. equals 5:3. Here 20:12 and 5:3 are two equivalent ratios of 10:6. Next example, find the values 12/15 equals to missing value by 5 equals to 8/missing value. Here 12/15 is equals to, if we divide numerator 12 and denominator 15 by 3, then we get 12 divided by 3 divided by 15 divided by 3 equals to 4/5. And 4/5 is equals to 4 × 2 / 5 × 2 gives 8/10. Therefore, 12/15 equals to 4/5 equals to 8/10. Here the missing values are 4 and 10. Like, we can solve more examples from NCERT exercise or examples. Thank you.